I did it. I just come into my stand, walked down the logging road where I thought that, where he laid down yesterday in the video, and he never moved. He died right here. And he is a stud to death. Oh, a big 9 point. Nice 9. And he has some mass to him. That's one of the most massive, thick antlered bucks I've killed. The biggest one I've ever killed in Arkansas. And I don't know what he'll score, you know. Probably about 130 inches. Maybe a little bit more. He's got a really strong main beam on this side, but it don't really matter to me. This is a trophy of a lifetime for me, and I look at everyone that I harvest like that. I don't get all caught up in how monster big it is, you know. I've been bow hunting for 34 years this year. And everything I do is on my own. I video myself. Be able to bring some pretty good footage to you, and I'm going to put it on YouTube for everybody. And, you know, well, what I did, I didn't stop him because I didn't holler at him because he was only about 11, 12 yards from me. And I was too scared that he might bolt. So I pulled back, and I'm sitting there trying to get the camera ready for the shot and all, and he was getting ready to walk out the camera frame, and I weren't rushing my shot, but I hit him back about right here, and it went through, and it hit his back leg, and it got his femur artery. And usually when you get the femur artery, it's a done deal. I killed several by hitting the femur artery. When you hit that, they bleed out on the inside. I knew he was seriously gone, you know, when he just trotted right up the from the drainage, and he fell over, and he stayed there that whole time. So I found him exactly where he fell. So I got me a really beautiful buck. Ain't that something? Look at that. Beautiful. He's got kind of a Roman nose to him right here. Beautiful crown. And look at those eye guards. I've never killed a buck with eye guards that big. He has beautiful eye guards. Beautiful. Last year, around the same time, I killed a nice little 10-point in here, but he wasn't as massive as this. He's about the same spread, and he's got some good tine length, but he's just not as massive, so. And he barely had any eye guards, about an inch and a half, inch and three-quarter. But I just want to say, first of all, that God bless me with this buck. I was sitting there praying on the stand, you know, for me to have an opportunity yesterday. And no sooner than I got through praying and talking to God, I looked up and I saw a doe. And I was like, hey, there's a deer right there. Started filming her. And what, 2 or 3 minutes later, I looked behind her and here he came. And he was on her. But absolutely amazing. Beautiful, beautiful buck. He's going to look good on my wall. I'm going to mount him myself. I started doing some taxidermy work. And I'm going to do this one myself. So to make it a little bit more special to you. But I just wanted to. My Luminox is still glowing. Excuse me, my Nocturnal is what it is. I'm using Nocturnals. And they work really, really well. But it is still a glowing. But he is a hoss. Look at that side profile. I'm going to let him lay here. And I'm getting ready to get my stand and go ahead and hunt this morning. And hey, I might have another bruiser come in. I might get lucky again. Of course, I'll be bucked out, but that's okay. I'll be able to shoot some does and video with everybody this year. So I'm going to go get in the stand here in a minute. And then I'll have to come and get him out. So he ain't going to be easy to lift. But we're going to do it. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thanks for blessing me once again in my lifetime, even though I do not deserve it.